Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Study Materials. In this video, we will discuss about the mechanical comparator. Before getting into this video, we will define what is a comparator. Comparator is a precision instrument and it is used for comparing the component dimensions with their working standard. In general, comparators have the following devices or components in their system: sensing device, magnification device and a display unit. Sensing device commonly used is a plunger or stylus which senses the change in length or flatness or any other dimensions. Magnification device is also called as an amplifying system. It may be mechanical, optical, pneumatic, electronics, etc. Display unit. Display unit provides suitable outputs or readings. A scale and a pointer is generally used as a display system. Types of comparators. Comparators can be classified as follows: mechanical comparator, electrical comparator, electronic comparator, optical comparator, and pneumatic comparator. Mechanical comparator. Mechanical comparator employs mechanical means for magnifying small deviations. The method of magnifying small movement of the indicator in all mechanical comparators are affected by means of the levers, gear trains, or a combination of these elements. Mechanical comparators are available having magnifications from 300 to 5000 to 1. These are mostly used for inspection of small parts machined to close limits. Dial indicator. A dial indicator or a dial gauge is used as a mechanical comparator. The essential parts of the instrument are like a small clock with a plunger projecting at the bottom. Very slight upward movement on the plunger moves it upward, and movement is indicated by dial pointer. The dial is graduated into 100 divisions. A full revolution of the pointer about this scale corresponds to 1 mm travel of the plunger. Thus, a turn of the pointer B, one scale division, represents a plunger travel of 0.01 mm. Experimental setup. The whole setup consists of a work table, dial indicator, and a vertical post. The dial indicator is fitted to vertical post by an adjusting screw. The vertical post is fitted on the work table. The top surface of the work table is finely finished. The dial gauge can be adjusted vertically and locked in position by a screw. Procedure. Let us assume that the required height of the component is 32.5 mm. Initially, this height is built up with slip gauges. The slip gauge blocks are placed under the stem of the dial gauge. The pointer in the dial gauge is adjusted to zero. The slip gauges are removed. Now the component to be checked is introduced under the system stem dial gauge. If there is any deviation in the height of the component, it will be indicated by the pointer. Reed type comparator. This is the diagram showing the reed type comparator, containing horizontal reeds, vertical reeds, spindle displacement, pointer, and a scale. Reed type comparator. The gauging head is usually a sensitive, high quality dial indicator mounted on a base supported by a sturdy column. The reed mechanism is frictionless device for magnifying small motions of spindle. It consists of a fixed block A, which is rigidly fastened to the gauge head case, and floating block B, which carries the gauging spindle and is connected horizontally to the fixed block by reeds C. Vertical reed is attached to each block with upper ends joined together. Beyond this, joint extends a pointer or target. A linear motion of the spindle moves the free block vertically, causing the vertical reed on the floating block to slide past the vertical reed on the fixed block. However, as these vertical reeds are joined at the upper end, Instead of slipping, the movement causes both reeds swing through an arc, and as the target is merely an extension of the vertical reeds, it swings through a much wider arc. The amount of target swing is proportional to the distance the floating block has moved, but of course very much magnified. The scale may be calibrated by means of a gauge block to indicate any deviation from an initial setting. Sensitivities of the order 0.25 micron per scale division. The mechanical amplification is usually less than 100, but it is multiplied by the optical lens system. It is available in applications ranging from into 1000 and into 500. Sigma comparator. This is the diagram showing the sigma comparator. It consists of a pointer, pointer spindle, driving drum, phosphor bronze driving band, Y arm, cross strip hinge, moving block, screws, scale, and bearing block. The plunger is mounted on a pair of slit diaphragms in order to have frictionless linear movement. A knife edge is mounted on it and bears upon the face of the moving member of a cross strip hinge. The cross strip hinge consists of the moving component and a fixed member, which are connected by thin flexible strips alternately at right angles to each other. Thus, if an external force is applied to the moving member, it will pivot, as would a hinge about the line of intersection of the strips. To the moving member, an arm of Y shape and having effective length L is attached. So here it comes, advantages. It is usually robust, compact, and easy to handle. There is no external supply such as electricity, air required. It has very simple mechanism and is cheaper when compared to the other types. It is suitable for ordinary workshop and also easily portable. Disadvantages. Accuracy of the comparator mainly depends on the accuracy of the rack and pinion arrangement. Any slackness will reduce accuracy. It has more moving parts and hence friction is more and accuracy is less. The range of instrument is limited since pointer is moving over a fixed scale. So this is a short video of the mechanical comparator. So if you like this video, please click the thumbs up button and also subscribe this channel and share this video to your friends to gain more knowledge.